Hello everyone and welcome to Sunburned Albino Plays Dark Souls. The first one. If it sounds like I'm less than enthused, I don't hate this game. I just hate every experience I've ever had playing it. Go ahead. This is gonna be something to see, something to experience again. Yeah, that's happening. Just yesterday, actually, I turned on Dark Souls. And I... I turned on Dark Souls. My second... Am I overburdened just by virtue of being a knight already? Alright. Well, that's gonna be great. Basically, I went and killed the Taurus Demon. And then... In the interim period after killing the Taurus Demon and finding no other bonfire, around that area at all, I got killed by one of those absurdly overpowered knights that are just unkillable, is how it appears to be. And so I was like, oh my god, I gotta run all the way over there, and I had like 7,000 souls, which is... a lot for this part of it. It's not an amount you want to lose. And then I got gang raped on the bridge, knocked off, killed by like 4 guys. And I was just like, you know, I think I'm gonna never play this game again. But then I was like, you know, wouldn't it be fun for the people, for the subscribers, if I played Dark Souls 1, a game I've never... beaten more than 2 bosses in. My highest level character was level 16, and I quit that run, and then I started a new run, and then that run's the one that I just quit. And now we're starting a new run, and I mean, it's gonna be, there's gonna be so much disappointment abound, and just so much me not enjoying what's happening, and it's gonna be a great time. This is a game where I don't understand half of the mechanics involved in it because they're so seemingly unrefined as opposed to later installments in the games. It's like if you start by playing Dark Souls 2 and then you try and play Dark Souls 1, it's just not. It doesn't stack up. And then, of course, you get people who played the games in the correct order. They're like, Dark Souls 2 fucking sucks. I braved Dark Souls 1. Dark Souls 2 is pussy shit compared to that. And you would think that because that was your experience with it. Whereas mine's been different. Okay. We'll just open the door. Previously, I thought you were supposed to kill this boss right now, as opposed to just running away. And that didn't work out for me too well. Yeah, no. No. Not dealing with you right now. How about we wait till we get my actual weapons? This straight sword hilt is not gonna be carrying me through to the endgame. God, look at this fucking shit. At least I got a tower kite shield. How much does this toggle status, please? Toggle the status that tells me what its guard is. Physical defense 110. That's not what I'm... No, toggle the status of the shield. How? Toggle display, that's what I wanted to know. Physical, 100% physical damage reduction. Good, that's what we're after here. This shield will be mine forever. Another part of it is, like, I'm back on 360. Because I'm playing this on the 360. And that's just shit. That's just... My 360 controller... Like, this is my original Xbox 360 controller. I haven't even gotten a new one. I mean, I have, but this isn't it. Like, I got the Batman Arkham City. All right, I'm doing 2 damage to him. Did I miss the weapon pickup? Was there a weapon pickup? I feel like there was. And yet I feel like I only picked up the shield. I'm so out of sorts when it comes to Dark Souls 1. It's like, what do I... Do you have a better sword? Broadsword. There you go. Does 4 times the damage. Actually does like almost 8 times the damage. I'm gonna make this dude my bitch now. I'm a fat ass. Yeah! I killed a man! And it's only gonna get easier from there. Yes, backstep. Yes, I know. I mean, there's not a lot to talk... I've given you... Wait, is it... Have I been... Oh, that's already the door that I came in. You know, take it or leave it. This is how this is gonna go. I'm gonna do really poorly. I see that block up there. Roll that shit down. Roll it down. There it is. That still almost hit me because it went off the side here. Go. No. That's unacceptable. You roll in a straight line.
Regrettably.
Yes, yes, I will do what you said.
Oh.
I've read that. I've read it all before. Now, let's change equipment. Oh no, the SS is already there. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, I picked fire bombs as a gift because I thought that would be the most directly useful. But yeah, I picked the knight character. I'm going tanky build. I will not be toppled. You can't topple me. You wanna topple me? You're gonna have to try real hard because I refuse to be toppled. I'm just telling you right now. I gotta be the fat bitch. The fat bitch untoppable build. Because that's all that we've got. That's all I have in this world. And it's my only defense. My first time playing this game, I tried to be the thief. I tried to be the whole, oh, I'm quick. And I'm prepared for this because I was so good at Dark Souls 2. But no. No, then no. Thief requires intimate knowledge of what's going on in here. Does my roll, like, take a ton of my stamina because I'm overburdened? No, it seems like it doesn't matter. I have to... What's my load? Equip load, 31 of 50. Do I have to take my hands off? Now it's 27. I'm still fat as fuck. What if I... Do I have to take the legs off? Or do I... They're the helm, I guess. Yeah, there we go. Alright. My character's not pretty. But he's, you know, he's a fresh, fat-faced man. Who just isn't ready for the horrors that are about to befall him. Short bow, that's nice. Alright, I actually got one of those to work. They almost never do. Oh, and you're not even dead. Oh, was that door locked? I mean, I guess I gotta go probably unsuccessfully fight the boss now. Die! I mean, I appreciate the, like, instant half-health takeaway that the plunging attack gives me. That is one thing I'll say about Dark Souls, where it's actually more lenient than Dark Souls 2, is that you can't actually block these, like, gigantic attacks. Like, even the overhead ones. Alright, good job. I mean, I fought this dude, the Asylum Demon, enough times that I know what's going on. This is the only boss, except maybe the Taurus Demon, where you'll see me actually mildly clean house. Okay, but we beat him. Where was I supposed to go after that? Oh, don't I open this door? There's another Asylum Demon, isn't there? Like, I hear it walking around. Make sure I don't miss anything. I should make very clear, feedback in terms of what the hell to do in certain situations is gonna be paramount to me not getting super pissed off. If I get stuck in a place, or if I have like a question about how to dodge an attack, or like how to most successfully defeat one of these OP starting enemies, please relay that information to me. I'm gonna try not to bulk record this series, A, because I don't think I'd be able to stand it, and B, so I can actually get the feedback in real time, or real enough time, that it would make an appearance in the next video. I can level up and kindle a bonfire at Lordran, which is so nice. Let's do it. What should I level up? Should I be tanky as hell, or should I increase my offensive skills since I start out tanky? Or should I increase my endurance, which is what I'm gonna do, because I feel like I do not have enough stamina at all. Alright. Maybe I should have started with the bandit class, because they had 14 endurance. That's kind of what I had going on. Yep. Dark Souls NPCs laugh at normal conversation. Anything, if there's something dreary going on that they're talking about, or did they find that so goddamn funny? It's like, oh, you might die if you go out there. Oh no, but I'm only jesting. No, but seriously, if you go out there, there's a good chance you'll die. Go, get out of my sight. Things to that nature. Oh, I have a bow, but I don't have arrows. So that's, I wondered if, like, you shoot the bird if something happens. I learned the hard way. You don't go this way. Don't go down here. Just don't do it. I mean, you can pretty successfully run down here and pick up some items. But don't you even think that you're gonna, like, continue along this cave the proper way. Because they do hella damage, and their lunging it happens. They lunge. Also, they follow me all the way up here. No. This isn't what happens. I gotta go rest at the bonfire right now. Where's it at? Where did it go? I don't know my way around this place. I thought it would be good for me to play Dark Souls. Like, I'm trying so hard to, like, push through to the end, but I just get so... I get so discouraged, because as the bullshit mounts time and time again. But I know I need to get through it, because I know I'm not giving Dark Souls, one, the chance or the objective sort of analysis that it deserves, being the first game, because I was so... basically spoiled playing the second game first, because the second game, like, I can see, like, this is so much harder than Bloodborne is. Like, I remember my initial playthrough of Bloodborne that was, like, blind, and I did, like, half of it. I grasped that game so much easier than this one, and there weren't a lot of cheap deaths. Like, the enemies, you kind of knew what to do. In Bloodborne, there weren't any, like, starting game OP, like, meant to be avoided enemies. And I already hate that. Like, I hate... No, I like that. I hate that this game has those. Because it's like, if I see an enemy, like, it looks kind of tough. Like, the knights in this, in that first section in this game, that are like, they have, like, the full armor and stuff, look like they can be dealt with. They just look kind of slightly more imposing than the regular hollows. But then you attack them and you do, like, 16 damage a hit and they have, like, 500 HP or whatever. And you're just like, where's the exploit? I need an exploit to kill these guys or it's not gonna work. Or am I even supposed to be attacking them? But that's what I'm saying, is like, you should, every enemy, like, you shouldn't just throw OP enemies into the mix as just, like, a thing to be avoided. Because if I see an enemy and it's, like, available to me to kill, I'm gonna assume that there's a way to kill it. Like, you're supposed to be figuring something out. Bullshit that I got poisoned, like, immediately, by the way. I don't have any antivenoms or anything. Does this poison ever run out? It's still at the top slot here. This is what poison is like in Dark Souls. It never goes away. You have to rest at a bonfire or you're just poisoned forever. Can the poison be neutered by, like, rolling in water somehow or something like that? Nope. Okay, fine. I'm going right back to the bonfire. We're gonna start this entire process over again. Because my broadsword slashes are too horizontal. But I can't, except they're also too vertical because I couldn't hit the rat that was directly in front of me. And they were too horizontal because they were deflecting off the wall. I don't know. Maybe only a certain type of Souls player that is in my subscriber feed will enjoy this playthrough. But, you know that I'm trying so hard. Also, I never finished my sentence earlier. I'm playing this game because I need, like, the lore references and just, like, the base knowledge so that I can get the most out of Dark Souls 3 when that comes out. Which, of course, I'm beyond excited for, and of course I'm gonna do multiple, almost certainly, playthroughs of it. Like, I watched... Of course I watched, like, Vaddy's, Vidya, or whatever his name is. Vadiavidia? Something like that? Like, I've watched the Dark Souls 3 coverage. I've seen those first areas. I know what's going... I wanted to, you know, see what we're getting into. And most people don't watch them because they're like, oh, spoiler, I need no spoilers, please. But I needed to know. I didn't need to know. But I was curious enough that I didn't care that it was a spoiler. I saw, like, the first three bosses and whatever. And I'm fine with that. I wanted to get a feel for, like, what kind of game it is. And people are saying, oh, it's, you know, it's more similar to, like, Dark Souls 1's combat than Dark Souls 2. And I was like, well, that... I would paint that as a negative, but I will find out, like, more once we actually get it. But, you know, it has, like, those lore surprises from all games. Like, NPCs would show up, and apparently you're, like, supposed to know them from Dark Souls 1, and I'm like, okay, I guess. People are like, oh, if you played Dark Souls 1, you'll recognize this character. And I was just like, well, I'm not really getting any of that, any benefit from that, because I haven't played Dark Souls 1. So I need to play Dark Souls 1 and get my frame of references going. And if I have to, and I mean, of course, I'm gonna play Dark Souls the cheapest possible, easiest way. Which I guess is actually, like, magic. But also, I'm uncomfortable with the thought of being a spellcaster in a game that I have no idea what's going on. Or I don't know what to expect. Like, for me, a melee build, it seems easier to adapt with. Okay. But I've cleared this area out too many times. Too many times without actually moving forward. And we'll get to see the results of that and how that comes to fruition. I hope to beat the tour. Let's see, 20 minutes in. I'll be able to get one attempt at the Taurus Demon in probably by the end of this video. Assumedly. Whether I actually beat him, which I should. The only time I lose to the Taurus Demon is if he knocks me off the bridge. Which I know where to stand so that doesn't happen anymore. You know, there's like a little crumbled place where the wall is dead. It's like, well, how about don't stand directly near that and just like, you know, prepare for the fight and know your surroundings instead. And I'm like, well, that's such a great idea. Oh, this is not the stairs. That was a dead end. Okay. Okay, they're dead. Keep being dead. Four hits? It takes three with the battle axe on the bandit class. I remember, like it was yesterday, because it was yesterday, just yesterday, that I was killing these guys with the bandit axe and getting really pissed off when they gang raped me. And it's not like that's something that happens a lot. It's just that, like, I was in a hurry to recover my souls because I had 7,000 of them after I'd just beaten the Taurus Demon. So I was like, I'm going to run across this bridge real fast and ignore everybody over here. But that was not the thing to do, because once you cross this bridge, like, they block that entryway. And then, you know, you've got firebombs and you've got the guys that were back here. Quiet contemplation as we clear this place out. That does not open from that side, and I don't know how to get on that side. Yeah, that guy's got a history of sneaking up on people, not me. I'm privy to what's going on here. I want what's in this chest. Oh, 15 black firebombs. Those are going to be helpful. I wonder how much damage they actually do. I wonder if maybe I can use black firebombs to do inordinate amounts of damage to, like, these OP soldiers that are coming up. Oh, you want to climb up here? I'm ready for you if you do. What the hell? Did you throw one straight up at me and, like, it went through the thing? Oh my god. Alright, you bitches. Ah, of course. Roll just a little too late. I'm ready for you. Fine. I'll eat that damage. They give me 10 Estus right off the bat. That's extremely generous. And definitely necessary. I was gonna say needed and necessary, so I went with necessary. Did these guys die? Did they all make it up here? I'm just a prom that danced a baby. And now I'm a-taking a stroll, taking a stroll. That's an oldie. Yeah, you like that shit? So explosive. So fiery. I'm ready for this one. What was that? What are you trying to... Why are you kicking behind yourself? And that's not Estus, now that I think about it. How do you kick, by the way? Nobody ever told me that. Like, I thought it was... I don't know what I thought it was. Isn't it... It's like... Oh, that's... A, okay, I got it. Stop. Okay. See, now this guy down here, how are you supposed to kill him? Because he takes no damage, he kills me in two hits, and I'm not going to deal with that right now. Good. Good. Throw that barrel down. Good. Come on. Come on. There we go. Run. Ah! Okay. Good one. And that's not even a backstab somehow. That's what I'm talking about. I never know how to get, like, directly behind people. It always turns into not a backstab. Didn't there used to be, like, a white dude? Like a guy with full white armor. I feel like he was somewhere. And he was also impossible to kill. Because they just love putting impossible to kill dudes out here. And there's an item in one of these barrels. Oh, it's a you! Why is it so difficult to kill? There we go. Twinkling Titanite, large Titanite shard. Nice. Okay, boss time. Let's do it. Let's not die. I shouldn't... Realistically, this fight should not kill me. Because I'm going to be really cowardly about it. With my shield up almost at all times. No, Estus is strictly for me. Do you understand? I am the chosen undead, so I don't want to see none of that. Okay, it's time to win. Run past these broken areas, because I ain't dealing with that. Nope, don't be knocking me off. See, Dark Souls 2 would never let you get away with trying to block that. But I'm glad that it does. Because I don't have the timing down to dodge these things the right way. I'm not even sure that I ever will. That just did damage to me, which is some bullshit. Yep. Again. I do flat out no damage to this guy. It's kind of pissing me off a little bit. Yes! A successful roll! Yep, good hit. Ow. Like that shit. Your attacks do nothing while I chip away at your health like it's supposed to be. No, 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 no! Holy shit. I would have fallen off there. That's what's unacceptable to me. Nope. It's like, yeah, like right there is the sweet spot to dodge. Go fuck yourself if you think you're knocking me off this thing. Well, why don't you stop strafing to where you're directly behind the point of contact at which you would then be knocked off the bridge? Good point. That doesn't mean that in practice I'm going to be implementing that strategy all the time. But know that I've taken your words to heart. Is this tail like a weak spot? I don't know. It like his tail almost feels like it's not even attached to his body. Or like it's attached, but like by a thread. You know what I'm saying? Oh no. Oh no, you missed that too. Good, yeah, keep doing the attacks that whiff magnificently. Oh, and then I whiffed an attack, because of course I did. Time to heal? He's actually doing a great job of not giving a shit. Oh shit. Yeah, I deserve that, I guess. Being too cocky. No. Oh, stop doing that. Alright. Why did you... why? I didn't want that. Nobody wanted that. You fucking idiot. I really thought I had enough time. He takes so long, like, after he drinks to even just, like, oh, my shield's still in my hand, should I be using that right now? Yeah, one humanity. Victory. We did it, you guys. Now I'm going back. Because there is no foreseeable bonfire onwards for, like, a long time before we can still get killed in the middle. So, back to the original bonfire. A successful fight, to be sure. I mean, you know, it wasn't flashy. But it got the job done. How do I get over here? That's what I want to know. I want to know all this stuff. You're not alive. That's good. Alright, we'll just travel back. I will use all my... What are you doing still alive somehow? Where did you come from? You cannot stack these surprises. Like, you can't trigger me like that, bro. Bro, you cannot trigger me like that, I swear. Swear to God, if you trigger me like that again. Okay. Well, let's do that. Let's eat a large soul. Let's eat another large soul. This is one of the main things I think Dark Souls 2 is better at, is inventory management. And the ability to eat as much as you want. at once, to be clear. Okay. Why do I only have 5 Estus? I had a maximum of 10. Let's level up. Endurance, like, 15. Strength, 15. And then Dexterity, 12. Should be enough for me to not feel quite so weak anymore. But that's that's gonna do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time.